So today, this project, okay, by popular demand, you guys, I think just one dude said that he wanted a before and after. So skip about 18 videos from here. But anyway, this project is getting a little out of hand. It's costing me way more money than I had budgeted for this. Okay, so let me start with, this is the, so you guys that wanted to watch the desk build, I cut this piece of wood without videoing, so we'll cut to the only thing I got from that. Okay, so I got this cut, and I'm building this whole desk out of MDF. If you don't know, that's medium density fiberboard, I think, or whatever. This stuff is, it's easy to cut, it's easy to mill, it's easy to sand, it's just easy to work with. But I really wanted to build it out of Burt's plywood, but I went to Home Depot, and that stuff was like $55 a sheet, and I was going to need like 6 or 7 sheets to do this whole entire thing. Well, this stuff was $31 a sheet, so I paid like $205 for plywood. So I budgeted myself $350 to build this desk with, right? But go on Amazon or go somewhere and like look at corner desks and see how expensive they are, and then imagine how much it would cost to have someone come out and build an entire built-in desk that would go all the way around to right here. Imagine how much it would cost to have a cabinet maker to come do that. You're looking at thousands and thousands of dollars, right? So I'm thinking $350, you know. I've got this on my other desk. The top of it was like hardwood, not hardwood, but like laminate flooring I just put on there. I'm like, I can do this and make it look, you know, decent on a budget. But the budget has like got blown way out, so because I spent like $205 on particle board basically, and then I bought black paint, right? So I'm painting the desk black. So I got a gallon of black paint. I'm not even going to use the whole gallon, but I discovered that it's stupid. We'll get to that. But I asked the guy, I was like, "Hey man, I'm painting like cabinet like stuff, or I'm pretty much just doing a desk." And what kind of paint do people use for that kind of stuff? And so he sold me on this premium, you don't have to prime and all this crap, way over $30 a gallon, right? So I got 1 gallon of that, and then I'm painting, and we're just gonna go ahead with this gray right here, and I'm gonna paint all the way up to that trim up there. I'm gonna paint the wall totally gray, just everything, trim and all. But when this is done, you'll kind of see the vision as it's going, or when I'm done. But anyway, I'm painting the entire wall gray, so I got a gallon of that, so I can paint this wall, and got something special going on this wall. We don't need to paint it. And I got a gallon of white. I'm sorry, I got a quart of just white paint. And you guys will see, if you're following along with this build, whatever, you'll see what the white paint is for later. And then I got me some of this pink spackling crap. I've probably got some of this somewhere around the house, but I can't find it. So I got this pink because it's pink when you put it on, and when it's dry, it turns white. I'm gonna spackle up some of the holes, and I'm about to start taking this trim off. And I got some paint supplies. I got paint supplies, but I didn't want to hunt for them. So I spent $130 on what y'all just seen. So what is that? That's like $335. I'm horrible at math. $335. I'm just like a few dollars shy of my freaking budget, and I'm not sure I got enough wood yet. I don't have nothing to put on the top. I don't have any nails or screws or wood glue or any of that crap. So this is not looking good for the budget. But the room decoration kind of don't count in the desk budget, but I don't know. Anyway, let's get started. I'm gonna pull this red. This is actually chair rail right here. This red stripe, that's like a chair rail. I'm gonna pull that off. I think I'm gonna leave, I want to redo the whole room, but I think I'm gonna leave the stripe from there over for now. right? I'm going to get this side done, and then I'm going to focus on this side. And I've got something going on this wall right here, and I don't know if I'm going to do the whole wall or just to the door. That stuff will be here. That's going to be a secret for now. I don't know, just to keep you guys watching. It's not going to be that great. But anyway, I'm going to start pulling this crap off. So let's go. Here we go. We'll take care of that later. So I'm left with some wallpaper. I'm trying to tell if somebody removed the wallpaper, if this has been painted over. I don't believe it is. I think what wallpaper is was just under the trim. Hopefully, I'm gonna kind of like putty knife this and spackle it up. I can't decide if I want to remove the cabinet yet, or just paint around it like a lazy person. I don't know if I'm gonna paint the cabinet yet. I hadn't made up my mind on that yet, cause that'll be in the background of most of my videos. I may have some wallpaper remover. I need to go get me a putty knife and see if I can at least knock down some of this stuff a little bit. I'm not worried about how. I know a lot of you people know like how like movie magic works, and I just pretty much want this to, you know, look good when I walk in here, and I feel like I've got a cool, you know, space to work in. But as long as it looks good on camera, that's all I care about. Because this is like, if I was to sell this house or whatever, I'm not going to try to sell this house with this room the way it is. I'm not trying to sell my house, but I got to think, you know, towards the future or whatever. So I don't want to like try to like screw up too much or make too much work for me later if I do try to sell this house, because I mean, I don't know, I like it here. I'd like to have a little bit more property. I'm fortunate enough to have the fire hall next to me to be able to fly in that field over there, that nobody's complained about it yet. So I'm gonna go find a putty knife and quit rambling to the camera. I'll be back. So I've decided that I'm going to take this cabinet down over here in the corner, and I don't have a ladder, so I'm gonna do it standing on this chair, this my kitchen table chair, and I'm gonna do it without taking all the stuff out of it. It's still full of crap. I'm probably gonna regret this. One more screw, come on, don't fall. I'm standing on my tippy toes. This is retarded. Yeah. I think I got all the screws. Oh shit. Oh shit, I think I should have emptied it. I got it. Lord. Yeah, okay. Next. Okay, so y'all gonna get a kick out of this. I couldn't find the stud when I was hanging this cabinet, so I just kept drilling holes. Like, it's gotta be here somewhere. Found it. Yeah. I don't have a stud finder. And this little technique. Hey, there's one right there. Yep. There it is, right there. I did find a couple of studs, but anyway, so I'm gonna patch up these holes, and golly, bum, there's a lot of holes. Let me show you guys right quick while I got you. Well, let's see if I can find the hammer. Let's see here. Ball peen hammer, perfect. Okay, so first of all, if you guys are in, I need you guys to comment down in the comment section, like right now. Do y'all want to see this kind of shit? Is this what y'all want to see? Is me working on my damn house? I mean, this is a dadgum drone channel, and here I am doing remodeling, but I'm not trying to. I have said before, if you've come here to learn something, you're in the wrong place. But I show you something I like to do that makes life a little easier, is I like to hit these holes that's in the wall with a hammer, right? And when you go back that way, they're not poking out. You don't have any high spots. So when you go to fill, them in, it makes it easier to fill them. So yeah, I'm gonna go around and I'm gonna peck all these things with a hammer, and then we're gonna spackle all these some bitches up and hope it dries pretty quick. It probably won't dry tonight. I don't know if we're gonna get the painting in this video. Oh, and another thing, like, I'm gonna go ahead and post this video, like whatever I got. But guys, you let me know if y'all just want me to make like one video of like the whole thing, or break it up into episodes. This is gonna be like a drone room remodel battle station episode one, I guess. That's the title. I don't know, we'll figure that out. But anyway, let me know what you think down in there, and then in the comment section, fellas, if you like this kind of shit, because I'll just keep on filming and keep on working. So I need to go ahead and get some mud on these walls so this stuff can be dry. I don't see myself being able to paint it tonight. Good Lord, this stuff's thick. Anyway, I need to go ahead and get some of this pink shit on the walls so I can be letting it dry and hopefully take care. I didn't realize this stuff was this thick. That's so thick. I guess that's a good thing, but it's gonna make this right here a pain in the ass. Ugh. Can you sand? Is this stuff sandable? Because if this ain't sandable, I need to quit. When ready to, oh, dries when ready to sand. Okay, so it's sandable. I've used this stuff before and it was like rubber and you couldn't sand it. That sucks. I ain't gonna bore you guys too much with this, so I'll just come back when I got all this done. Okay, well, I got that stuff put on there, and honestly, I think it looks like shit, and it's kind of embarrassing because that pink crap that I used, I don't know, if you're familiar with like joint compound, that stuff's like creamy. You can like mix it up, and the more you mix it, it gets the air bubbles out, and you can just, it's just smooth. You can lay it on there, and you feather it in and everything. Well, this stuff is like organic peanut butter or something. It's like super thick. My arm is hurting from trying to smear this crap. It's thick. I can't think of the consistency to describe this stuff, but I could not get it to, I mixed it, but anyway, I had to put it on there with that stupid putty knife. You know, usually you use one of these tape knives, you know, it's real wide and you get it nice and you can like feather it, but I just couldn't do that this time. I bought the wrong shit. It's my fault, but anyway, that's gonna do for today, guys. I'm probably just gonna do videos in stages like this because I really can't do much else. It's still daylight outside. I can go cut some wood and everything, but I'd rather like get this wall done and painted and everything before I kind of like, because I'm going to have to build this desk like in place and paint some of the parts like as I go and everything. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. We're this weekend, this is Thursday. You guys are going to be watching this on Friday. So this weekend I'm going to like get as much done as I can in here. I'm not going to do any flying. I'm going to spend Saturday and Sunday in here and try to get at least the desk roughed in the best I can and try not to spend any more money. But I still got to do the top of the desk once I get the desk built. But anyway, we're going to try to get this desk knocked out this weekend. I hope that's the plan. You know, setting goals, set them high. Get the desk at least in here and like built, and I can start painting on it and stuff like that. So, appreciate you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Oh, I forgot. Subscribe, damn it!